The following is a class on the Srimad Bhagavatam, 1st canto, 3rd chapter, text number 27, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on October 2nd, 1972, in Los Angeles.
Translation: all the rishis, manus, demigods, and descendants of Manu, who are especially powerful, are plenary portions or portions of the plenary portions of the Lord. This also includes the Prajapatis.
So, Prajapati, the beginning, there was only Lord Brahma, the whole planetary system was to be populated. Therefore, first of all Brahma, then the seven rishis, then the Kumaras, then Rudras, in this way, Manus, then Manus' son, his son, his son, in this way, the whole universe is populated. It is not the rascal Darwin's theory that there was no human being. It came out of a stone, the life. The first is the most intelligent person, Lord Brahma. They are called Prajapati. Praja means generation. Pati means master, husband. So all these Prajapatis, as we learn from Bhagavad Gita, Manu ikha kavi bravid, vivasan manave praho, vivasan, sun god, he spoke to his son Manu, vaivasyata Manu, imam vivasati yugam praktavan aham abhayam. Krishna said that first of all I told to Vibhasha, the sun god, and then he described, he handed over the knowledge to his son Vibhasha, Vaivasyata Manu. This is the age of Vaivasyata Manu. So in one day, there are 14 Manus in one day of Brahma. So, in one month, how many? Eh? 220. In this way, in one year, there are so many Manus in Brahma. Some 5,000 Manus in one year. So many Manus and his sons are coming. Manu, from Manu, the word man has come. Manushya. The man, this word, is from Manu. We are all sons of Manu. There are two descendants of Manu. Two descendants, Kshatriya family, one from the sun god and one from the moon god. Two families, Kshatriyas, royal order. So Manu is from the sun and the descendants, Surya Vamsa, they are from Manu. Manu Ikkhaka Vibhavid. Manu, his son was Ikkhaku, Maharaj Ikkhaku, king. He was the king of this planet, the original forefather of Lord Ramchandra's dynasty. Lord Ramchandra appeared in the family of Manu, and similarly Surya Vamsa, similarly Lord Krishna also appeared in Jadu Vamsa. So these families, dynasties are very, very old. According to Vedic system, any family, Brahmin, Kshatriya, Vaishya, those who are higher caste, they must give at least 7 generations account, otherwise he is not a respectable family. 7 generations. His father, his father, his father, his father, his father, like that. When there is marriage, then there is check, corroboration. The bride's party and the bridegroom party, they should narrate their 7th generation. If the 7th, within the 7th generation, collide, becomes one man, then there will be no marriage. Because it becomes the same family. One cannot marry in the same family. He must pick up another family. Otherwise one could marry his own sister. No, that is not possible. This family descendants, still there is gotra. Gotra means in which family one is coming. Everyone must say his gotra and family title. Gotra means the guru, disciplic succession. Achyuta gotra. We, Vaishnava, our gotra is Achyuta gotra, Krishna. Krishna's name is Achyuta. Because we give up our other family gotra, we accept. Actually, originally, everyone is coming from Krishna. From Krishna, the Karunanam Sai Vishnu, from Karunanam Sai Vishnu, Garbhoduk Sai Vishnu, from Garbhoduk Sai Vishnu, Brahma, from Brahma, the sages, the Manus. In this way, everyone is descendant from Krishna. And Krishna confirms also in the Bhagavad Gita, Sarvajuni Sukantiya Sambhavanti Murtayaja Tasang Mahajani Brahma Aham Bijapadam. I am the origin of seed-giving father. Trees, plants, aquatics, by their karma, they have to accept different dress, but as spirit soul, everyone is part and parcel of Krishna. That is also confirmed in the Bhagavad Gita. Mamayivangsa jiva bhuta. So, it is said here that Manu putra mahajasa. Of course, those are Prajapatis. They are very famous. Naturally, they are the original. But all of them are Kala, Sarvi, Harir, Eva. Kala. Kala means just like part of the part of plenary expansion of Krishna. Then the expansion of the plenary expansion. Then again expansion. In this way, the first expansion is called Prakash. Just like first expansion is Baladev from Krishna. These things are described in teachings of Lord Chaitanya. You must read. The first expansion is Baladev. The next expansion is from Baladev, Sankarsan. From Sankarsan, Vasudev, Aniruddha, Pradyumna, like that. So, the first expansion is called Prakash. Then there are divisions, Prabhav, Vaibhav. In this way, as you have learned from previous verses, many thousands of expansions. We are also expansion, but we are separated expansion. Living entities. Sangsa, Vibhinnangsa. Sangso, just like this my hand is my part and parcel of my body, direct expanse. And from the hand there are so many hairs. They are also from the hand. That's my head. And from the head there are so many hairs. So they are also expansion. So they are separated expansion. I can cut my hair, but I cannot cut my throat. So, there are expansion, sangso, personal expansion, and separated expansion. The personal expansions are called Vishnu Tattva. Baladev, just like Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, his personal expansion is Nityananda Prabhu and Advaita Prabhu. And Shivashadi, they are separated expansion. Although they are associates, but Shivas, Jiva Tattva, and Nityananda Prabhu and Advaita Prabhu, Vishnu Tattva. And Gadadhar is Shakti Tattva. So in this way, God is person and his personal expansions are innumerable, unlimited. The Vishnu Tattva, they are worshipable. And Adhar Tattva, Shakti Tattva, and Jiva Tattva, they are meant for service. But all together taken, there is one. There is absolute. So there are many different philosophical views of the Absolute Truth, how He is one with the energies and the separated expansion. So here it is explained that Kala Sarve Harir Eva. Everyone is expansion from Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead. But those who are prominent, they are called Prajapatis. Prajapatis means directly expanding. These Kumaras, they were also offered to become Prajapati, but they refused their father's request. So we are not going to marry and beget children. So Brahma was angry. So when he was angry, then Lord Shiva, Rudra, from his eyes generated. In her circle, the generation can be produced from any part of the body. But we cannot understand. We simply know one part where from the generation comes. No. In her circle, just like many living entities came out from Brahma's nostril, eyes, ear. Just like Lord Brahma himself came out from the navel of Vishnu. This requires a specific power. Not that we have got some stereotyped ideas. Therefore we sometimes find a difficulty to understand the description of the Vedas and the Puranas. They do not believe. As soon as we say that there was a lotus flower sprouted from the navel of Lord Vishnu, and on that lotus flower Brahma generated, they call it story. No, these are not stories, these are facts. But our philosophy is doctor's frog's philosophy. You see, I can simply understand that 3 feet water in the well, that's all. If there is beyond that a description of Atlantic Ocean, it is beyond my conception. I therefore refuse. This is not, this is the so-called scientist philosophy. They have got a teeny brain which they cannot accommodate so many big things, therefore they disbelieve. and therefore they are nastic. But every description in the Vedic literature, that fact, that is called astik. To have staunch faith, our process is therefore, whenever we speak something, we have to quote some Vedic version. Then it is corroborated, it is fact. Janmardasritaha, Vedas, Vedanta says, the absolute truth is that which is the origin, source of everything. There must be something, original source. Otherwise, how things are coming? This conviction means faith. Now Krishna says, sarva-dharmān parityajamāmekaṁ saraṇaṁ vaja. So those who will argue, why shall I surrender to Krishna? But one who will accept, he becomes benefited. So Vedic knowledge should be accepted as it is. Don't try to comment. If you go on commenting with your teeny brain, then you will never be able to achieve the success. That is the process. Vedvan, I have given you several times this example, that in the Vedas it is said the cow dung is pure, although it is the stool of an animal. We accept, yes, it is pure. And actually you find here it is pure. If you analyze, you will find all antiseptic properties. Now how in stool? Stool is septic, septic tank, whereas stool. But this stool is impractical, you can see. But where from we get this information? From the Vedas. The knowledge received from the Vedas, there is no mistake, there is no illusion, it is perfect. Just like here, we have read the passage, 4 lakhs of years, 400,000 of years after, from this time, there will be incarnation of Kalki. His father's name should be Vishnu Joshi. The place where he will appear, there is Sambhal. Everything is stated there. Now 400,000 of years it will, Lord Buddha appeared 2,500 years after the Bhagavad was written. That came a fact. So if we take the Vedic statement, Vedic literature statement as fact, then our knowledge is perfect. You don't require to research. There is no need. It is perfect knowledge. And very easy. Krishna says that imaṁ vivasyate yogaṁ praktvānāṁ aibhvayam. So Krishna said this. Arjuna was playing just like ordinary man, although he is not ordinary man, just to give us lessons. He was asking questions, just like ordinary man. So when Krishna said that I spoke this Bhagavad Gita, science of God or philosophy, to Vibhushan, the sun god, he clarified the matter. He said, Arjun said, my dear Krishna, you are my contemporary, of the same age, so how can I believe that you spoke Bhagavad Gita some 400 million of years ago to sun god? How can I believe? So Krishna answered, yes, you are also present, but you have forgotten, I remember. That is the difference between God and human, living in. God knows everything, past, present, future. We do not. We are teeny. We cannot be equal with God at any stage of life. Even Arjuna, who is constant company of Krishna, he is also forgetting. Krishna replied, both you and me had many, many births. We appeared, but you have forgotten. I remember. That is the difference. So the difference between God and ordinary living entity must be there. Anyone who is claiming as the Supreme Lord or God is a blasphemer, is a rascal, is a cheater. So you should not be influenced by such rascals. God is always great. There is no equal, no greater. That is called great. Nobody can be equal with God. Nobody can be greater than God. Everyone under God. Asamardha. Therefore, God's another name is Asamardha. A means none. Sama means equal. Urdha means greater. Asamardha. So everyone is emanation from God, but nobody is equal with God. But the Vishnu Tattva, they are the same. There is no difference between Krishna and Ramchandra, Narayan, Vishnu, because they are Vishnu Tattva. Baladev, they are equally part. But Jiva Tattva, we living entities, although we are part and parcel of God, we are not equally part. That is called the philosophy of Achinta Bhedabhed Tattva, simultaneously one and different. Simultaneously one and different. Just like in Bible also, Jesus Christ is claimed as one with God, but at the same time different. As Son, He is different. As representative of God, He is one. That is the philosophy, perfect philosophy. All living entities, anything within this manifestation, even this whole world is one with God. Idam hi visvam bhagavan ivetara. Narada Muni said to Vyasadeva, idam hi visvam. This whole universe is God. Idam hi visvam bhagavan, the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Ivetara, but it appears like different. So now, according to this formula, idam hi visvam bhagavan, then forgetfulness of Bhagavan, forgetfulness of relationship with Bhagavan, Krishna, is materialism. Actually, everything is Bhagavan. But when we forget the relationship of this world and Bhagavan, Krishna, that is materialism. Just like we are offering some foodstuff to Krishna. So Krishna is eating matter? No. Krishna cannot eat matter, he is spirit. Then how you are offering the same rice and dal to Krishna, which is also being cooked in the hotel? The thing is that here is the sense that this rice or dal is given by Krishna. There is remembrance of Krishna, therefore it is spiritual. And they are in the hotel, they do not know Krishna. They are eating matter. That is the difference between matter and spirit. Actually, everything is emanation from Krishna. So there cannot be anything matter. Idam hi visvam bhagavan. But the forgetfulness, the material world is, what is this material world? This material world is, everyone is forgetting Krishna. Their only business is to forget Krishna. Therefore it is material. But if Krishna consciousness is there, the material, no more material world. Just like this temple. This temple is spiritual, Vaikuntha. It is not Los Angeles. Don't think like that. It is Vaikuntha. Because here every second the remembrance of Krishna is there. Therefore it is not Los Angeles. Or anyone who remembers Krishna always 24 hours, he is living in Vaikuntha. He is not in the kingdom of Maya. That is required. Satatang chintayantang ma, always thinking of me. In the Bhagavad Gita you will find, satatang chintayantang ma. So, if you keep this practice, always thinking of Krishna, then you are not in the material world. You are always in the spiritual world. For practical example, just like there are foreign embassies in foreign countries, so long they are within the embassy, they are not living in the foreign country. That is the law. Suppose I belong to some foreign embassy. So I have done something criminal. So the American government cannot arrest me from the embassy. When I come out, he can arrest. So, ships also, when they are on the port of a foreign country, so on the ship also, the foreign police force cannot arrest anyone. These are the etiquette law. So if it is possible in ordinary dealings, then why not possible spiritually? And that's a fact. If you keep always yourself in Krishna consciousness, you do not belong to this material world. Then actually you are part and parcel of Krishna, your spiritual identity. Thank you.